everyone. My name is Baru, and today we're going to be talking a little bit more about Battleborn. Now, in the last video that we ended up making, we had a bit of an interesting discussion. Everything was kind of thrown all around. My thoughts, opinions weren't really organized in any kind of way. So we're going to kind of take a minute, take a step back, and go over what exactly Battleborn actually is, and then we'll move on to the discussion of this video. So to start things off, let's go ahead and go over what exactly Battleborn is. I noticed in a lot of comments in the last one was like, yep, it's a MOBA. That's what I feared and that's what I don't like. And I'm here to tell you that it's really hard to kind of convince people that it's not a MOBA. And I can honestly understand why people think that. You know, when I was playing it myself and the people I was playing it with, they were like, oh yeah, this is a MOBA. And it's not really meant to be. And the developers are trying to convince people of that. The reason that it originally started as a sort of MOBA type thing was because Incursion, the original mode, the mode that we're currently playing, was the original game mode that they actually implemented. They don't want Battleborn to strictly be a MOBA game. What they want to do is take elements from the MOBA style and implement it into a different way here. So they want to have your character level up each time, and they want to have all these variety of characters. And yeah, you have this game mode that is very similar to a MOBA playstyle, which is you've got minions, they move up, you try and take out the turret, and you just continue this two times, and you win, and you've got lanes and all that. So yeah, you know, it's got a couple of the things that make a MOBA a MOBA. But much like Borderlands, they didn't want to just, you know, make a standard game. They wanted to take elements from a variety of different games and kind of create this, I guess the best way to put it is this really weird harmony between all of the different elements. And that's what they're trying to do with Battleborn. And it's really hard to try and convince people that it really isn't something that, you know, watching the gameplay and actually playing it for itself, I can definitely see and understand the difference in why everyone has issues with, you know, the game itself. Not everyone can completely agree with what, you know, what is being shown with them. And I completely understand that. But to move towards the topic of this video now, I kind of want to go over the whole shooting the game down before it even launches. Now, I can agree that when the pre-sequel ended up coming out, I hyped the hell out of that game. You know, I was all about it. I was like, oh yeah, here we go. Pre-sequel, 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 pre-sequel. Let's go, let's go, let's go, let's go. And I ended up not actually liking it. That's because I got a very small piece of what the pre-sequel was, and it didn't fit for me. Now, there are those who enjoyed the pre-sequel, and more power to you. You know, if you were a fan of the pre-sequel, continue being a fan of the pre-sequel. And you know what? Honestly, the first playthrough, it's an enjoyable playthrough. I liked it, but it didn't really incentivize me to keep playing it, and I feel a little bad for overhyping something. And I'm not trying to overhype Battleborn, you know? I want to give people an honest opinion of what Battleborn is, and I want them to give it an honest attempt and an honest try here. I see a lot of people shooting it down just for the simple sake that it's not Borderlands. And I gotta say, we gotta move past that mentality. Gearbox wants to move past that mentality, trust me. I've had a talk with the developers themselves, and they're like, give us a shot, you know? If it ends up bombing, then let it bomb. Let it actually launch first, and then we'll see how exactly we, you know, feel about the game. Let's not kill it before it even goes first. And that's what I kind of want to... That's kind of the topic of today's, the whole reason for today's video. In the last video that I made for Battleborn, I saw a lot of just shooting the game down before it even launched. And I think we should give it an honest attempt. Now, I'm not going to go the full hype train like I did for the pre-sequel. And I honestly, you know, I'm going to admit, I learned my lesson there. Let things just happen naturally. If it's going to be good, let it be good. I mean, hell, Borderlands 2... Yeah, it had a little bit of a hype train behind it, but nobody expected it to be as big as it was. Borderlands 2 is the most popular game that Gearbox pretty much made. And it's ridiculous how popular that game was. And you know what? We didn't expect anything from it. We didn't. When Borderlands 1 came out, you know, it was a neat game, but it wasn't the best thing that's ever been. So I think we should have the same mentality going into Battleborn. It's a new IP. It's meant to be something entirely different. And I think we should give it its honest attempt. And we should let it see where it goes. If it ends up flopping, then let it flop. But that's where I don't want to repeat myself over and over again for this entire video, but I'm going to say it one more time. For the sake of all these videos and the future videos, we're going to let it sink or swim. We're going to let the game decide where it wants to go. Personally, I enjoy Battleborn. Am I hyped for it? I mean, honestly, I'm not hyped for any game that comes out anymore because I have no idea what to expect until it actually launches. I've seen many games that are like, yeah, I'm ready for it. And then I get there and it's a pile of garbage. I've seen that for many games. It's just how games are in this year. Everything wants to drive the hype machine behind what exactly is being launched. I mean, The Division, everyone's hyped for it. It put me to sleep. I'm sorry. The game is literally you walking around with a gun, a regular gun, in basically an empty New York, shooting basic people. It's like GTA with health bars, but without the wacky stuff of GTA. That's how I felt about it. It was just, it put me to sleep. And that thing has such a huge hype train. And I that's how I look at games now. I don't get hype for them. I'm going to see what piques my interest, and I'm just going to follow the game around and make videos and content around what I enjoy. And Battleborn, after my playthrough, I enjoy. And I think my community that I have slowly grown here on YouTube and on Twitch as well will enjoy Battleborn once you get to see a side of it that I've gotten to see. Granted, I can't show you that side because I'm still under NDA. But there's a little bit of a hardcore player in me that enjoys things that are going to be in the game, basically. Again, I can't talk about it, but I think people will enjoy it. And I'd like to hear everyone's thoughts and opinions on this as well. I freely open discussion about all of this. Granted, I'm not as active in the comments section as I would like to be, because I'd love to just, you know, open up and just spend 8 hours a day typing up comments, but I frankly don't. But please leave your comments in there. I do read pretty much every comment on my channel, at least for the first 24 hours. So, you know, go for it. I want to hear what people's thoughts on it. What are your fears? What is it that makes you scared about a game, and what makes you follow the hype of certain games? Also, I had to taunt this person every now and then. I gotta throw in that taunt. But anyway, the next few videos that I'm gonna be making are gonna go over a little bit more in depth as to what the incursion mode is, each of the characters, their classes, their abilities, their general overview. We're gonna have a video going over the actual loot system itself and how exactly you can acquire loot. And again, if you missed the last video, I want to let everyone know the loot in this game, you acquire 100% in the game. You're not going to be seeing a Mass Effect 3 multiplayer, which I played a lot of the Mass Effect 3 multiplayer, so, you know, the whole, hey, we've got all this loot, but you can buy it to go faster, that's not going to be a thing. Granted, there will be DLC that comes out in the future, but, you know, I can't really talk too much about that, but it's not a bad thing. I mean, hell, every single game at this point has DLC. It's just how the company makes a little bit more money. And speaking of which, if this game actually does end up being a success, that will only help Borderlands 3 in the long run. Because I know everyone wants Borderlands 3. Trust me, I'm aware. Gearbox is aware. 2K is aware. We all know that we want Borderlands 3 to be around, and we want it to be good. But something to remember is that, well, they want to make more than one game, and they need money to do it, you know, and they want it to actually, they want it to be good, right? They want Borderlands 3 to be a good game, and that takes time, that takes effort. Trust me, if we launched Borderlands 3 right now, it would be a pile of shit. You know why? Because it didn't have enough development time. I prefer games to actually launch when they're ready, not just because we have to hit a deadline and we got to make some more money, which is honestly what happens with a lot of games. And I'm not going to say that happened with the pre-sequel, but it definitely didn't. I didn't feel the full-on labor of love with the pre-sequel as I did with Borderlands 2. It could have definitely sat in the oven for another year before it ended up, you know, popping out. But then that would end up, you know, being an issue with Battleborn. So I can kind of see why they did it, but, you know, I wouldn't expect anything on Borderlands 3 at least until the end of this year at the earliest, because we want it to be good and we want it to be finished. So don't expect anything on that for quite some time. I know people are going to keep, don't worry, I know people are going to keep asking Baru, what about the Borderlands 3? What have you learned about Borderlands 3? Is it gonna be good? And to that, I keep telling you, the only thing I've learned is that it's in development. You won't believe me, but that's where we're at on that. But I think this has been a fairly good discussion. You know, we've gone over a variety of things here. And I want to have more of these type of conversations with you all every now and then. I don't know, maybe I should have more of those Baru talks, but just not so depressing this time. Just you know, let's talk about the game and all that stuff. But those are my thoughts and opinions on, you know, everyone basically shutting this game down before it's even launched. And honestly, I don't like following the hype machine, but at the same time, I don't like condemning something to failure before it's even had a chance to see if it can even stand on its own 2 feet. Let's give it the same treatment that Borderlands 2 had, which was, hey, it's there. Go try it. Oh my god, it's amazing. Or, you know, we can give it the same treatment as a pre-sequel, which is, oh my god, it's amazing. Oh. Rip. Well, that's pretty much what I wanted to get out of the way. So, here are the plan. I'm just going to go ahead and go over the plan again for the next couple of videos. The next video that we are going to be making is going to be going over the loot system and the currency system and everything that you can end up expecting from that. We're going to try and go as in-depth with it as we can. Granted, remember, I had a little bit of corrupted footage, so I'm going to have to Frankenstein that whole thing together. So that'll be real fun to try and put together here. And on the 23rd, I've got a 1-hour interview with Gearbox that will hopefully alleviate a lot of your concerns. And then, you know, we've got, after that, we're going to go over in depth with each of the characters. I got a chance to go over all 25 of them, and I will actually be able, I actually confirmed it, I will be able to actually talk with all 25 of the characters, so it should be a fun time. Also, to hell with this penguin dude. To hell with him. I love Toby, and I hate Toby. That damn mine is annoying. I don't know how to feel about it. I should also get this chair done. Like, you can hear that squeak, can't you? You probably can. I am so very sorry about the squeak. So we're gonna go in depth with each of the characters, and I know some people were asking, like, you can upgrade these characters, right? And you can. You can upgrade these characters. And I asked them, they said it'll take about, if you wanted to fully complete a character, and I mean 100% the character, which means you got all of their challenges done, you got all of their, you beat the entire, you know, you beat everything with them, you leveled them up fully. I'm not talking about campaign. This is, don't take this as, you know, do the campaign with them as well. This is just to fully level them up. And this is including their cosmetics. The actual leveling up for the gameplay doesn't take as long, but it still takes a decent amount of time. But to completely finish off a single character, you're looking at about 15 to 20 hours per character to fully finish them off. And that includes all their custom skins, their lore. You actually unlock their lore via challenges, which I think is kind of a neat thing, you know? If you want to learn more about the character you're playing as, let's say you find a character that you actually really enjoy, and you want to progress more with that character, you want to get a deeper meaning with that character, you can actually finish their challenges and, you know, you'll get their entire backstory and things like that. And hey, if you don't want to actually unlock their backstory and you want that, I'll probably make a video on each of the characters. Partially looking forward and partially not looking forward to getting 20 hours on each of the characters. But I mean, hey, I had like 5,000 hours in Borderlands 2, so you know, I've got
plenty of time to get it all done.
I've got plenty of time to make it all end up working there. So anyway, you're looking around 20 hours or so to actually finish each of the characters. And that's a very good chunk of time. And like I said, each one is actually pretty in depth with how much customization they've put in the characters, the skills, and all that. And honestly, I wouldn't be surprised if they do end up including some paid DLC for customizations, like, you know, skin packs and all of that stuff. That's perfectly fine to me. If they ever make DLC for things like that, you know, go ahead. Make a little bit of extra money. As long as they don't include any kind of paid gameplay, you know, outside of like adding in a new character, because again, that's fine as well. But, you know, as long as they don't include like, hey, buy a legendary loot pack. But, you know, skins are fine because honestly, once the game is finished, the art team has nothing to do. They just sit there. It's like, oh, what do we do today? I don't know. The game's finished. Oh, okay. Well, let's make some skins. All right, let's do it. So, you know, I wouldn't be surprised if we end up getting a couple of different paid DLC skins and things like that. But shouldn't expect too much in the way of paid gameplay. But that is pretty much everything for today's video. I want to thank you all for watching. If you enjoyed this video, if anything for you, if you like, hell, if you even just like the voice, you know, do me a favor, hit the like button. It does actually greatly help me, and I would appreciate it a lot. I'll be making more videos throughout the week going over Battleborn, and, you know, keep an eye on my channel for all your Battleborn needs. Or if you don't have a need. I'm not the boss of you, okay? You can do whatever you want. I'll be over here. I'll be over here. But anyway, if you haven't already, consider subscribing, get notifications as to when videos go live, all that good stuff. And I guess I'll catch you in the next one, everybody. We'll probably let the gameplay run its course here. We got like 2 minutes left or something like that. This match is basically almost over. I should probably commentate one of my matches. I'm not gonna lie, I'm a little disappointed. I went like 20-1 in the last PvP match that I did, and it got corrupted, and I'm sad. I'm very, very sad that I didn't end up getting a chance to show that. I was OP. I did the thing, and I was only playing as, like, you know, good old Oscar Mike, and that can really show that, you know, sometimes just a standard character can really wreck shop if you know how to play them right. Ugh. I'm hype. I'm happy for this. Not hype. I'm happy. I want more of it. Anyway, that's the end of the video for the commentary. I'll let the rest of the gameplay play out. Thank you for watching. Catch you on the next one, everybody. Later.
Yeah. action!
Outcast thrall detected. Only one hostile remains. Press the advantage. Thrall mercenaries deployed. A sentry is under fire.
Keep away from me!
Do you have any idea who I am?
Power play. Only two hostiles remain. One hostile remains. Press the advantage.
Oh!